As much as I enjoy and have affection for the places and things we have seen or visited these last 2 days, the marshes, the dunes, and the yopons, and the horses and birds that are still there, I am reminded that it was, and still is, the people who once lived there that mattered most then and now. Some of you have seen the video montage that was on display in the museum hall this weekend. As I observed the faces of those who stood and watched, I noticed their amusement when they saw the old schoolhouse or the wooden bridge. I saw their interest when they noticed old faces that looked so much like newer faces we still know. But I had been most aware of their genuine excitement if for only 8 seconds they caught a glimpse of a face belonging to someone they loved. And as we talk about them, show their pictures, tell their stories, it's not just them that we are honoring and remembering. Ultimately, it is more for us than for them, because in them we are reminded that we too are important. Even in the face of all that we see and hear and learn about the great and wonderful and sometimes terrible world we live in, our ancestors remind us that we really do matter, because someday our children and grandchildren will tell stories and show pictures of us. And when they do, they will smile and laugh, and sometimes maybe even cry, with gladness or sadness, or both. What binds us to them is not their distinct or amused accents, or their maritime professions, or even their talents and instincts. What truly binds us to them is that they love one another, and that some of that same love still lives in us. If my grandchildren someday reunite to remember Susan and me, along with their parents, aunts, uncles, and cousins, it will not be because of my profession or my distinctive accent. It will be because they will remember the love they have felt when they were with us. Most of us hunger for real roots and foundations. Over the years, when decoy carvers are asked why they started or started back practicing the art of carving, they mention their father, their grandfather, or their uncle and conclude, "I'm just doing what I saw them do." It can be said that the grand purpose of this museum and of events like the Diamond City Reunion that are at the heart of the museum's mission is to remind us that we have roots, solid roots that have withstood storms equal to any we are facing today. When the crowds left the banks, they assembled in their newfound communities as families. Reports of census takers for the next 50 years give the appearance of having been sorted by some key field in the census taker's handbook. Instead, they are merely listing the names in the order they find them, one extended family, or more especially one crowd following directly after another. That practice was evident not just on the rolls of the 10-year census list. For several generations, Promised Landers were called the crowd from the banks by their Morehead City neighbors. Folks from Soldierpath even today are lumped together as that crowd of Soldierpathers. Over the years, I've been reminded more than once that I am one of that crowd from Harker's Island. Standing before you today, please know that I have never been ashamed that you are my crowd. And I hope that you and yours will never be anything but proud of our shared heritage, and that those who shape that heritage, both living and deceased, might always be proud of us. My grandfather, Charlie Hancock, moved from the banks on Christmas Day of 1900. 57 years later, he died and was brought to lay in state in his own living room on the shore, and facing the banks he had left more than half a century earlier. My father, along with my aunts and uncles, took pains to make sure that his grandchildren understood and appreciated my grandfather's legacy. And so now, 57 years after his passing, and on this special occasion, I offer a goodbye to him that I was too young and immature even to think of on that occasion. Goodbye, old Pa. Goodbye again. I hope that you can be proud of me and mine, and that we are still your crowd. All of us gathered here for this reunion have an old Pa and an old Ma, and one of the very best ways that we can honor them is in the lives we live here and now today. Thank you.
How